Hello, Umut here. Welcome to another video. Today I have my napkin journal in front of me. I'll quickly show how I keep them in a traveler's notebook cover that I keep all of them. And today I'm going to work on a really simple and quick page that is suitable for all the beginners out there, or you don't have time and you want to play in a really short time. I just sprayed my pages, which are mixed media paper, with some water, and then I'm using some distress spray stains in just browns and neutral colors, earth colors. I'm going to put down the colors that I used down at the description area, not to worry. And I'm just mixing some oxides with these normal sprays, spray stains. I think they have a lot of depth, the oxides, when you mix them with normal sprays, so that's what I am doing here. This is antique linen in oxide, and the rest was normal spray stains. And my napkin is this beautiful palm trees. It has a little bit of a desert feel to it. It's like looks like a palace in Middle East, in the middle of desert, with like palm trees and sand. I don't know, at least this is what I'm dreaming in my head. I just ripped off one of the palm trees and a couple of leaves that was on the napkin. And by the way, thanks so much to all of you who sent me beautiful napkins. So I'm just journaling with all those napkins that were gifted to me. I'm really grateful for all those generous and kind people out there to share our supplies and art. I removed the backing of the napkin, and my page is all dry now, and the hazy color that you see there is the oxide, because the antique linen has oxidized when I used water on it. And I'm just gluing my napkin with matte medium. Before you ask me, yes, the sprays move, and I'm just going over them with matte medium. I'm just gentle, and I'm using a dry brush. I'm not like smooshing over my pages hardly. I'm going to use paint with my hands, so I'm just covering my hands with this ArtGuard cream. Just to be safe, because the paints have some chemicals, and if you use with a brush, it doesn't have any harm, but if you use with your hand, it goes to the skin. I'm using three paints here, three colors. You see the names of the colors on the screen while I'm using them. My objective is to make these napkins disappear into the background so that it looks like one cohesive piece of art. I'm just going to cut this part, which I forgot to do before. And you will see in time, when I use colors on top of each other, these will look like a part of the page. I brought in some darker color of olive that I think was needed, that is closer to the color of the leaves. This is a olive color from Arteza that I have in my color of 60 set. I have a discount code from Arteza if you want to purchase their paints. I'm going to leave the links down below. They have sets of 12, 24, 60, up to 60 nice acrylic paints that you see from the tube here, and it's quite a good price considering the amount of colors you get. And as you see, the more I apply some paint here and there with the colors that are similar to my napkins, the napkins are disappearing into the background, and it's becoming a nice art journal page. I think this is a great exercise for beginners who are not sure about colors, or you just want to practice. You don't need to decide about the colors. The napkin comes with its colors, and you just see and accommodate the rest of the page according to what you see on that napkin. And I really like the process of this matching the colors and playing with the background. It's really soothing and meditating, especially in these days that we need a distraction. I really enjoy my napkin pages. I think I'm really happy with it at this stage. I'm just going to use my oxide in antique linen to make some splashes. It looks a little bit hazy, and I like the look of it because of the oxides. And I'm going to just throw some water with my hand to activate those splashes for them to make a little bit of oxidation as well. And I think I feel quite happy with it. I'm just going to dab out all the water that's there to let some of the splashes stay. And lastly, I'm going to use this Tim Holtz sticker set in craft color. They have white as well. Pulling out three words out of it: earth, leaves, and love, which is what I see on my page. Finally, I'm going to give a darker border. You can use many tools for this. Your inks. I'm using gelato here in a dark brown color. Or Faber-Castell pit brush markers. There are many options to give those borders. You see, it's giving a really nice definition and a good frame to draw the eye inside. And I think I'm done with it. It's really simplistic, but looks really nice. There's a hazy look of it. I love the palm trees and all the colors on it. It's very earthy. And I enjoyed my time a lot. I hope you enjoyed it too, and it inspired for you to do the same. Get a few colors and a napkin and play with your art. Wish you all a great week. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.